If they like you too much, they'll offer you coffee or tea. That's if the people are good. Hello guys, welcome to my channel. If this is your first time here, welcome. Please subscribe and hit the notification bell so you'll be the first to be informed each time I upload a new video. If you're an old subscriber, thanks for always coming back. I appreciate your love and your support. So on today's video, I'm going to be talking about what I hate in France versus Cameroon. Before I start, a little disclaimer. This is my own opinion. I'm talking from my own perspective. If you don't agree with me, don't come here telling me that no, it's not like this or it's like that. I'm telling you what I personally hate. That is what I prefer in Cameroon, okay? The first thing I hate in France is old people's home. You know, in Africa or in Cameroon, when you are old, we love our parents to come and stay with us so that we can take care of them. Here in France, it's not the case at all. Once you attain a certain age, you can't stay with your children. You'll be sent to old people's home where you'll be catered for. I don't really like the idea because it's like you're almost like rejected. You are somewhere you are being catered for, and mind you, it is extremely expensive. Maybe it's because of the lifestyle here or what, but you will hardly see a child stay with her parents or with his parents here. It is extremely difficult. You can't find that. In Africa, we love to take care of our parents. We like to keep them by our side. We provide for them. We give them everything. But here, it's not the case. Many Africans here prefer to go to Africa when they're on retirement because there we have our family that will take care of us. But here abroad is not the case, especially here in France. Once you attain a certain age, you are alone. Your children are somewhere working or living their lives. You go and stay in old people's home and they can only pay you a visit once in a month. And some people don't even come to see their parents. They only hear one day that they are dead for them to come and take their cups and bury. So that's something I really hate. It makes me sometimes feel bad for them because at the end of the day, I feel like they are rejected, like they are not good. And I actually think they are lonely, because when you meet an old person here and he or she engages a discussion with you, that person can take forever. Because she has found, or he or she has found, someone with whom he can discuss with. He's going to tell you almost all his life story, his biography. If you don't cut that discussion, the person is likely to discuss almost the whole day. Because at home, they have nobody with them. Even the old people's homes, each person has the room. So they mostly meet sometimes during dinner together to discuss, but most of them are in their rooms lonely with TVs. Honestly, I don't really like that. It makes me feel so bad. It's not, I personally wouldn't want to spend my retirement here in France. It's something I don't admire, because we Africans, we love taking care of our parents when they are old, but here it's not the case at all. Another thing I hate in France versus Cameroon is neighbors. Can't believe it. I have been in France for almost 4 years and I don't even know my neighbors. I know like 3 of my neighbors, but if I see them on the way, I won't be able to recognize them, because you don't have contact with your neighbors. No, you don't. It's not like in Africa or in Cameroon where you can actually go sit down with your neighbors, discuss with them, have dinner with them, play with them, have a drink with them. Here in France is not the case. I believe that they know me because where we live, my husband and I are the only black people there. They know there's a black person staying there, but they don't know my name. I don't know their names. We just like sometimes we'll say hello, we'll say good morning, but we don't know each other. We don't sit to discuss with each other like in Cameroon. You don't have that person that you can just go and knock on the door and discuss with them. No. Or ask for assistance when you need help. It is extremely difficult. On some rare cases, you can always like ask a helping hand, like when you want to carry something heavy, if they are there. Sometimes they are even there and you knock on their doors, they won't even open. Like, it's not as if I like intruding or I like going to people's houses, but staying somewhere for almost 4 years and not knowing my neighbors and not even knowing their names, it's something that I don't really like. Somehow it is good because you avoid these neighbors' problem, but the fact that you don't even know their faces is a problem. I don't understand how people live like that. So it's something I really hate in France here. The third thing I really hate in France is taxi. Taxis here are extremely expensive. You can be in a taxi, trust me, at the end of the day you can end up paying 100,000 francs. Or which in Cameroon, we can pay taxes for 500 francs when we are going for long distances, or 100 francs short distances. Here in France, trust me, don't stop a taxi because you'll be sorry for yourself. The further the taxi goes, the meter reads, the more you pay. It is calculated according to your distance, and trust me, it is not cheap at all. It is extremely expensive. So that's something I don't really like here. If you don't have a car or bus stops around your area, you are likely to stay at home because taxis are extremely expensive and you can't afford to always spend huge sums of money on taxis. The fourth thing I don't like in France is hairdressing. Hairdressing is extremely expensive. Like, we Africans here, we get creative. If you don't know how to make a wig, you learn how to make a wig. I personally never knew how to make a wig, but coming to France has taught me to make my wigs, because hairdressing is expensive. You hardly see Africans go to do their hair in saloons. Not only is it scarce to find an African salon where I live, but if you succeed to have one, it is extremely expensive to do your hair. So many Africans do their hair within themselves, or learn to make wigs or buy wigs because it is affordable and cheaper for them. You know, with wigs you can wear and repeat and repeat and repeat, and they're always still good. They're going to do your hair like we do that in Cameroon. Like in Cameroon, you can do your hair after every 2 weeks, after every month. Here is not the case. Sometimes you see somebody with braids that have been like 3 months here. I'm sure the person is just like thinking how she is going to spend that huge amount of money to redo her hair. It discourages people here. So that's something I don't like. When I was in Cameroon, I like doing my hair every 2 weeks or every month, depending on what I have on or what I want. But here, we put on wigs or we just shave the hair. It is no big deal. You can't afford to spend all your savings on hairdressing. No, we can't do that. We can't do it. We don't want that. Okay. The fifth thing I hate in France is uninvited visits. If you go to somebody's house uninvited, if that person is so good, the person will open you the door. Sometimes the person won't even open the door for you. Just the way they will welcome you, you will know you are not welcome. Some people will just like open the door and you're like, they'll just open the door and they're spying you. That means the door is half open, half closed, the way they look at you to talk to you. Sometimes they'll open by their windows and they'll talk to you through the window. But if they're so good, they'll open the door halfway, half open. If it is midday, time to eat, my brother, my sister, get up and leave. Get up and leave. Because when they are eating, your share won't be there. They won't put you amongst because they weren't expecting you. If they are so good to you, they will be on the dining table eating with their kids and you're on the couch. What they will give you will be conversation. If they really like you, if they really like your presence there, they will discuss with you, and that's enough because you weren't invited. It's not like in Cameroon that you go to your neighbor's house or you go to anybody's house uninvited, and if it's time to eat, they make sure they give you something. Here is not the case. You don't go to somebody's house uninvited, and if you go to somebody's house uninvited, don't expect to have something to eat like in Cameroon. Don't expect that because you will be disappointed. If they like you too much, they'll offer you coffee or tea. And that's if the people are good. That's if they really like you. That's if people are actually very close. If not, in most cases, some people even tell you to leave, that they want to eat. Some people are very frank. Some people will keep you there. They'll give you coffee or tea. You'll be drinking or you'll be sipping, and they'll be somewhere devouring their meal or what they program for dinner. So that's something I don't really like. It keeps me uncomfortable. I don't do that. Seriously, I personally don't do that. If you come to my house at any time and it's time to eat, I will always give you something. Like, I remain African. I remain a Cameroonian. Come to my house at any time, you will eat something before you leave. I don't know. It's a culture. I can't take it away. I just believe that somebody comes to your house, that person should be welcomed. If at least that person must have thought of you before coming to your house. The person won't just get up and come to your house without like thinking about you or You know, I just believe you should just welcome somebody that thinks of you and comes to your house. Especially here in Europe, visits are actually very expensive. For somebody to think of you and come to your house, that person is really your person. That person likes you. If not, in most cases, you can spend months without seeing people. And let me tell you something. Some of us Africans are even worse than these whites. Some of us Africans who will come to Africans or Cameroonians, when we come abroad, we even become worse than this white. Like, we practice their culture even more than them. You go to your brother's house, you don't even have water to drink. I'm not saying that if I go to somebody's house, it's an obligation for them to give me something to eat or to drink. No. I'm just telling you what I don't like about French culture, or what I don't like in France versus Cameroon. Because I know in Cameroon, if you go to somebody's house uninvited, you are likely to get something to eat, or they will even propose you a drink if they don't have food. But if it is time to eat, trust me, they can't eat without giving yours. They can't do that. They can't. But yet in France, they'll be looking at you in your eyes, straight in your eyes, and they'll be eating, and they'll be enjoying their meal, and they'll be acting as if you're invisible. Like, how do you even digest? How do the food descend? Like, I don't get it. It's something I don't still understand till now. The last but not the least thing I hate in France versus Cameroon is friendship. You know, in Cameroon, you can meet somebody and you quickly click with that person. You can become good friends. You start sharing one or two things, giving assistance to one another. Here, friendship takes time to build. Trust me. It takes time to build. And you might think that person is even your friend when actually you click, or you start visiting each other, you start calling each other, you think that you people are friends. Trust me, you are not friends. In Cameroon, we have that knowledge that my child is your child. My children are your children. But here in France, it's not the case. Even when you are friends with somebody, you can't even give your child to somebody. You can't say, please assist me with this child for 1 hour. It is not being done that way. You are going to pay that person. If it's your best friend, she will charge you. You'll be shocked. You might think this person is your friend. Give your child to that person to keep for 1 hour. When you come to pick up your child, you receive a bill. She will tell you that your child was here for 1 or 2 hours. I don't know the time that your child was there. She will give you the number of hours the child spent there, how much she'll be charging you, how much is an hour. She will tell you. If the child took a biscuit, what they call snack or goûter, they call it goûter, yeah. If their child has eaten a piece of biscuit or granite, she's going to write it down that your child ate maybe 1 yogurt, took a piece of biscuit, or took this or took that, and she's going to bill you up. In France, you can't trust anybody with your child without payment. You have to pay that person for the person's time. Like, in Africa, in Cameroon, you can leave your child with your neighbor, you can leave your child with your friend, your best friend. So here in France, if you are lucky enough, like me, I'm lucky to have friends that are good. We assist each other. I'm blessed for that. I thank God for that, because I can actually leave my children sometimes with my friends, whom are actually very good, whom I thank God for, who are extremely loving and caring. Same thing with me. They don't expect anything in return, but in most cases, trust me, you won't find that. You won't be that lucky. You won't be this lucky like me. Like, I'm lucky, you know, I'm lucky. So that's something I really hate in France. In Cameroon, you have a best friend. Your best friend is almost like the mother to your kids, you know. But here, it is not the case. Their child remains your child. You don't keep their child with me without paying me. You have to pay me. You have to pay me for my time. You have to pay me for my services. So that's something I really hate in France. So guys, that's the end of this video. If you haven't subscribed, like, what are you waiting for? It is completely free, guys. Subscribe. Hit the notification bell so you don't miss out on any video. Make sure you stay tuned for my next video. Bye.